Good morning to all. It's a great honor and privilege to present some of the most striking features of the e-filing module, paperless court and e-office, the pride projects of the High Court of Kerala. Before I start the presentation, I would like to place on record that we would not have been able to successfully implement the modules without the encouragement and guidance given to us by the chairperson of the Supreme Court E-Committee, the Honorable Dr. Justice D.Y. Chandrachud, our beloved Chief Justice, Justice S. Manikumar, and the Honorable Judges of this court. The government has been very considerate, and if they had not acceded to our request for resources and assistance for developing our infrastructure, nothing would have been possible. I thank the Honorable Chief Minister, the Law Minister, and the officers of the state for their support and cooperation. I would also like to acknowledge the valuable inputs that we've received from the Vice Chairman of the SCE Committee, Justice Chavan, the AG of the State of Kerala and his team of officers, the ASG and his officers, the lawyers of this court as well as the subordinate courts, the Advocates Association and the Bar Council of Kerala, the clerks and the association, our registry and the IT Secretariat. Without further ado, let me just take you through the features of the modules that our developers and engineers have developed. The process of e-filing starts from the advocate's dashboard. This is the facing page of the dashboard. The dashboard would show the total number of cases filed by the particular lawyer who is registered with the dashboard from the date of commencement of his practice. It would also show the cases which are pending, the cases which have been disposed of, the entire orders, judgments, etc. We have taken care to ensure that the module is developed, keeping in mind that the lawyer concerned may have filed cases in various capacities. Some of the cases may be as the lawyer representing the parties, some as a standing counsel for some organization, and some as a party in person. A single profile has been allotted so that he can access all these cases in one place. The details of the registered clerk of the lawyer is also added in the dashboard. The next important feature in the advocate's dashboard is the advocate's calendar. By looking at the calendar, the advocate concerned can have an exact idea of the number of cases listed on a particular day. He can accordingly plan a schedule. Through the dashboard, the advocate can file fresh caveats, counter affidavits, objections, interlocutory applications, urgent memos, etc., etc. The advocate can also apply for certified copy of the orders and judgments, and the orders will be delivered to his dashboard. A copy will also be sent to his registered email ID. Now, we will get to the feature where the advocate can file and register the case online. This is the window for the e-filing module. There is a standard feature where the advocate can fill up the basic details and proceed to register the case online. After receiving input from the lawyers, we found that the procedure needs to be more simplified. We have therefore added a new feature which we call the quick e-filing procedure. The entire procedure can be completed in just 4 steps. The advocate needs to enter the essential case details, upload the case files, make e-payment and submit the case. The most important feature is that the advocate can, through internet banking or UPI, remit fees including advocate and clerk welfare fund fees, and the amounts were remitted would be credited to the treasury account in real time. This simplifies the whole process. One of the best features in the dashboard is the option for the lawyer to view the details of all the cases that he has filed. The advocate can know the status of the case and view all the records presented by him or the other side in that particular case, and if required, take printouts as well. In the conventional method, the advocate was required to serve copies at the counter or any document which is relied on by him to the other side. With the dashboard in place, the moment the documents are uploaded,
it comes to the dashboard of all the advocates who represent the parties to the proceedings. Thus, even if the case bundles are not with the advocate concerned, if the advocate has an internet connection, he can access all these details on his mobile phone or computer. We have also introduced an option to clear the defects online. If defects are noted by the registry, the advocate concerned will get a mail or a message and he can enter the dashboard and take steps to cure the defect. The next feature is the option given to the advocate to opt for a video conferencing or advance arguments in hybrid mode. He can, by logging onto his dashboard, place a request to opt for video conferencing, and by doing so, he can address the court where cases can be heard on a hybrid mode. We have created similar dashboards for the government pleader, the private secretary of judges, and also the officers of the registry. Now we come to the judges dashboard. Clicking on the roster wise pendency, the judge can get a clear idea of the total number of cases pending before the judge and also the subject wise pendency. If the judge clicks on a particular subject, a pop-up showing the total number of cases and the average disposal per year will come up. From the said data, the judge can understand the time frame required for disposal of the entire matter in that particular subject. If the judge clicks on the rectangular pink bar, the case numbers of the pending cases will pop up. This shows that the entire data is mapped. The next important feature is the work assessment of the staff working under the judge. The judge can evaluate their work and performance and ensure that there is no delay in concluding the work assigned to them. The next feature is the ability to search the case files of any type pending before the court. The judge can open the machine-readable PDF file of any of the documents presented before the court. The documents can be seen in split view and also a combined view, and a search option is also provided. These files are having optical character recognition facility, and our server is having the capability of reading machine-readable PDF documents. The judge can also see the IA details, write or dictate notes, and see the electronic order sheet. The next feature is the online cost list, from where the judge would be accessing the cases on a daily basis. The judges can also take copies of the petitions, counters, etc., make marks and endorsements on the same using the stylus, and save a password protected copy in the PC. Microsoft OneNote software is being made available so that judges can prepare notes while hearing arguments using the stylus. Voice recognition has been enabled, and it is possible for the judges to dictate orders by using the speech to text recognition.
Admit, issue notice to the respondents.
One of the most outstanding features is the ability to access all books and journals through the dashboard. Most of the legal softwares have been integrated with the dashboard, and the judge is not required to enter the user credentials. The e-Granthalaya, the entire repository of High Court judgments, and the High Court e-Library can be accessed through the dashboard. The next feature is the option given to the judge to digitally sign orders and upload the same if the situation so warrants. In certain cases, the judge can also upload the order summary with great ease and convenience and with the least amount of assistance from the staff. This would be of great assistance when it is difficult for the court to function in some situations. Now we come to the dashboard of the Honorable Chief Justice. This dashboard has all the features that are there in the judge's dashboard. In addition, our developers have harnessed the transformative potential of artificial intelligence and machine learning to generate roster analysis. The Chief Justice will be able to generalize, with the aid of intelligent graphs and charts, the subject-wise pendency of cases, the reasons for the delay, and the approximate time frame within which the cases can be disposed of. The graph which you see on the screen shows the roster analysis. If you look carefully, the blue rectangular bars with the court number on the bottom shows the total number of cases pending before each judge. The green line on the top shows the total number of years within which the case can be disposed of. As you can see, the attempt must be to straighten the green line and to make efforts to lower the peak. For which purpose, it is possible to allocate a particular jurisdiction from one roster to a selected roster by the click of a mouse. This graph shows the data of all cases disposed of till date and pending. If you place your mouse on a particular bar, you can see the total number of cases which have been disposed of and the cases which are pending at present. In addition to the Chief Justice's dashboard, our developers have also developed a dashboard for administrative purposes. The said dashboard would contain the service and personal details of the entire High Court staff, the entire staff of the District Judiciary, and the judicial officers of the District Judiciary. Now we come to paperless courts. Two courts at a magisterial level in the state have been converted into truly paperless smart courts. One is the additional Chief Judicial Magistrate Court at Thiruvananthapuram, and the other one is the Judicial Magistrate of the First Class at Kolanjeri. To our knowledge, these are the only two smart paperless magistrate courts in the country, and both the courts are presided by lady judicial officers. In the paperless smart courts, interoperable criminal justice system known as ICJS has been put into operation. It is thus possible to consume all documents, including metadata, forwarded to the court from the prosecuting agencies, based on which reports, including summons, can be automatically generated and the same can be digitally signed. The digitally signed summons can be electronically forwarded to the police station for effective service. The entire filing in the smart courts is done using e-filing version 3. Evidence is recorded in the smart court using voice-to-text software, and the evidence so recorded is signed by the witness concerned by affixing a thumb impression through a gadget. Smart screens are provided to the counsel appearing for both sides and also the witnesses, and they can view the deposition while the recording is in progress. A fully fledged video conferencing facility is enabled for hybrid hearing as well. Now we come to the court of the Honorable Chief Justice. The first court is the first truly paperless court in the High Court. Smart computers are provided to the Honorable Judges, and 4 touchscreen PCs are provided to the counsel for the petitioners, respondents, and the government pleaders. As of today, 6 courtrooms have been fully transformed into paperless smart digital courtrooms in the High Court, and in a few months, all the courts in the High Court of Kerala will be transformed into truly paperless smart courtrooms. The next highlight is the implementation of the latest e-office file management system in the High Court. Implementation of the e-office in the High Court would bring about revolutionary changes in file management. The movement of files would be fast, efficient, and transparent. Justice Mohammad Mushtaq, the chairman of the Kerala High Court Committee in charge of computerization, has named these projects as Virtual Office, One Go, One Platform for Everyone. We are certain and hopeful that the projects that are going to be inaugurated today will bring about transformative changes in the justice dispensation in the state. Thank you.